Welcome to this introduction to the new Hansoft API that is a part of version 11.1. Why do we care about the Hansoft API? Well, it is the fastest way to automate or integrate your plans and tasks in or to Hansoft from any other system. So if you have tried to do this with Hansoft before, you might have done this with the software development kit, which is fairly low level and a little bit difficult to get started with. And especially compared with this API, there is a huge difference. The API is well packaged on top of the SDK, actually, so it doesn't have the same in-depth possibilities as the SDK in every way, but you will find a much more of the business logic actually built into the API that makes it faster to work with. You communicate with Hansoft using GraphQL. So if you are familiar with this query language or used it before, this will be very easy and fast for you to get started with. Otherwise, I would recommend that you also browse graphql.org, where you can find examples for a wide range of different programming languages on how you can use this. You don't need anything else as a Hansoft user. Your normal username and password will be used to authenticate to Hansoft, so you will not be able to do anything that you're not allowed to otherwise. One thing that is different, though, from the administrator's perspective is that there is a API service that needs to be installed for the end users to have access to this. So it's the same way as you would install other integrations or services that we have, that you will add a SDK user to authenticate between this service and the server and point the service to where you have downloaded the SDK to. And then it will install a number of third-party libraries as it's running on as a node application. That's everything you need to do from an admin standpoint, but then as an end user, you don't have to do any of this. You would just get started with GraphQL. So, since this is a tutorial, I just want to talk a little bit about what GraphQL is and how it works before we go into the playground with the API. So when you're writing your client that's going to communicate to the Hansoft server, you have three main ways of doing that with GraphQL. So you can query data. So that means essentially I'm reading data. I will show you an example when we're reading projects. Then you can subscribe to different events. So for example, project updates. So that will allow you to be, if you're building a real-time application with this client, you would probably use a lot of these subscriptions. And then as soon as you want to modify anything, it's called a mutation in GraphQL language, so create, update, or delete any data. And with these requests, you're sending in variables with the dynamic values that you have, and then some kind of HTTP headers for the authentication that's needed, so we know who you are when you're talking to Hansoft. So that's probably enough PowerPoint for this tutorial. So let's go into the playground. So by default, it will be on port 4000 and then /GraphQL that you can find this playground. And on the left-hand side, that's where you're entering your queries, for example, or your mutation in this example. On the right-hand side is where you see the results. And then you will find the documentation and the schema here on the right-hand side. If you're going to see this or not depends a little bit on how you have set up your API service. The first thing that we're doing here is that I have written before we started a mutation on just how to log in. So it's going to be a good time to pause if you're following along and type in the same thing I've done here. And then ensure that under query variables, you typed in your username and your password here. When you run this, the result on the right-hand side will give you a access token. So you want to copy that one because now I want to get started and writing a new query from scratch here. So let's say now we want a query that just gives us a list of projects. And we want to get the ID of projects and we want the name of projects. You'll see how we'll pre-fill all the fields and stuff that is in the API for you automatically. And now we need to use that token that I just copied there. So I'm going to go in here and I'm going to say we want to have authorization. Sorry, should I put that in quotes? Should be the bearer. And then I paste in that token. So let's see what happens. So now we got our list of projects. These are all the projects that are in this server that I'm connected to. And you can change this to anything. So if I want to get the list of users instead, you simply would type in users and then you will get the list of users. And the reason I'm getting this is because I am a user that has administration access to this. Let's say now that we want to write instead a subscription, for example. Instead, we write the subscription and we say we want to look for projects added. So all the projects that's been added. And then we want to look at the ID and the name of those projects that are added. So now it's going to say listening here. Now it's saying listening, and then we're going into Hansoft and we're adding a new project. So project test, for example. And no, we don't have to add any user. So now I have project test right here. And if I'm looking at this API, it will now tell us that project 2599 project test was added. So even though I did that change from the client or anywhere else, I can now track all of the changes to project added. So let's say now that I want to rename this project. So I remember the 2599 there, that's going to be important. And then we want to write a mutation here instead. So the mutation in this case, I'm going to call it just, these are written a little bit differently from the queries and the subscriptions. And then we will specify that I need something called, and I can just call it input. And that's going to be of the type update project input, like that. And then we want to then specify update project is what we want to do. And update project input will be then the input variable here up there. And then after that, we want to send in an ID, and a name is what we want to get back as well. And in this case, I'm going to change over to the query variables down here. And I want to add then that we want to do the input. We want the ID. I'm going to send in a couple of different things here to be 2599. Nope. I want to just to call this. And then I want to do a name in here. So this is where I will enter the new name because I can't change the ID, of course. So let's say we just want to call this one Project Y. And then we stop the previous subscription that was running and then we run this instead. So now this project 2599 should be called Project Y instead. So let's go in and validate that in Hansoft that yes, it is indeed called Project Y. So that was a quick introduction to show you how you can work with queries, subscriptions, and mutations. And as I mentioned, you have the documentation, the schema for everything you can do in the playground or in our documentation. If you have any questions, any feedback, feel free to reach out to our support. And yeah, good luck with the API. We're looking forward to see what you're doing with it.